I have a basic Pro Tools session here with dialogue, music, and effects. In order for me to have better control over the gain of those individually, what I can do is I can put all my dialogue tracks together on one bus and all my music tracks together on another bus and my effects on another. And that way, I can do a sound mix, I can get all my levels that I want, and then I can control the entire group of dialogue tracks with one fader. It also gives me the ability to do a final sound mix with everything combined but separated. So let's take a look at how we would do that. Right now, Pro Tools sends the audio out to the analog output, which is just the output of the box, but I have the ability to route the audio internally. So let's go ahead and make some auxiliary buses. We're going to go over to our track window and we're going to make new tracks. And I want to make three tracks right now. I want to make three, and they're going to be stereo, and they're not going to be audio tracks this time. They're going to be auxiliary inputs. Okay. Right now I have 1, 2, and 3 tracks of auxiliary inputs. Now I want to make the input of my dialogue track bus 1 and 2, input of my second track bus 3 and 4, and the second input 5 and 6. Okay, I'm going to rename these tracks real quickly. Auxiliary 1 is going to be my dialogue aux, and then my next track is going to be my music aux, and my next track is going to be my effects aux. Okay. All right. So now I have these three trucks going to analog 1 and 2. All of them are going to the right output, but I still need to get the audio from the individual tracks to these auxiliary buses. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to my dialogue track. I'm going to select bus 1 and 2, and my other dialogue track, select bus 1 and 2. Now my audio is going to be playing from dialogue through the auxiliary bus. So now you can see the audio actually coming from the dialogue track and not going out directly to the analog, but it's going through a bus. So now I can control both of these tracks with just one master fader. Okay, I would do the same thing with the following tracks. Music track would go to bus 3 and 4. And then my effects tracks would go to bus 5 and 6. Now every single track that I made, if I have effects 1, 2, if I go up to 32 tracks, I all have them routed to bus 5 and 6, and any combination of sound effects can be controlled by one fader, and that's a great advantage.